snow has been down for 5 days. And as you can tell, this is quite a steep hill as well. And it's a challenge, to say the least, to get up here. Being so close to the edge that I was I'll try and stay away from me. By the way, I don't have the kids with me today, so I'm here on my own. Now, the only problem that we've got with this hill, because it's so steep, I am unable to get into a slightly higher gear from first. I'm in low range, diff lock engaged. I can't get into second, because if I try to get into second, it will just die. Simple as that, it'll just die because of the steepness of the hill. Let's try that again. Nice and slow off the clutch. Nearly at the top. This will be the hardest part. We do have another little stretch a bit further up. Don't think I can have any problems getting out of there. We'll find out, I'm sure. I've had this Land Rover now, this is the third year, and to tell you the truth, this is the first time that I've ever driven in snow this deep, so it's a steep learning curve for me as well. So I don't want to roll back too much. If I roll back too much, I could end up too many rides. You know, it's starting to flatten out about right here. So should make driving conditions a little bit easier.
very deep up here, and you don't really want to get stuck up here. There are a few stretches on the way back that if I get caught in it, I'm not going to be able to reverse out. And I'm certainly not going to be able to get back up the way in the direction that I'm going now. So I'm. And another thing as well, if I do get stuck, I don't have anybody that's going to be able to come up here and get me out as well. So I'm going to have to. I think I'm going to go back the other way. I'm trying to find a way now. But turning around somehow. That is a bit mad, that is, I think, going up there. So now we're going to go back down. But yeah, just step out of the truck a minute. I'll just give you an idea of how steep this is. Right. That's behind. Now I'm holding this pretty much flat. And if I spin right the way around, and that's what I just come up. There's your trusty friend. Geez, very deep snow. Way over my ankles. Well, that's the old trusty friend. There you go. Wavy, don't know why. Oh, nice and wet. Right there. Let's carry on. Otherwise, I'm never going to win. I haven't got stuck in this so far. It's been quite good in that respect. well. That's not good. Side. YouTube, I think. Just trying not to do that again. Tell you what, I certainly wouldn't want to be a farmer living up on the top of this, and there are a few farms up on this mountain as well, so I certainly wouldn't want to be one of them, even in a Land Rover Defender. I'm not saying that this couldn't do it, all I'm saying is that I'm not capable of doing it, but as I mentioned earlier on, this is the first time that I've gone in deep snow. And I guess the more I do it, the more confident I'll get. So, anyway.
My main fear in this Land Rover is actually getting it stuck like up there when we was pretty much the wing mirror on the left hand side was touching the bank. Really, really, really don't want that to happen, and if that happens, I think I'd be walking on, to be honest. I do have a winch on the front of the Land Rover, but as you can see, it's just, well, I don't fancy just dragging the Land Rover on its side, to be honest. So I'm gonna give up. And from what I saw up there as well, there's a lot of snow down up here. It's got to be about a foot and a half to 2 foot in places, and I'm not willing to risk this Land Rover. I don't think the police would be too happy with me anyway if I did get it on its side, or the insurance company for that matter. Going down this hill, I'm doing roughly around 5 miles an hour. I'm in low range, first gear, and death lock is engaged. It's not sliding at all, it hasn't slid once. I feel quite safe driving. So I'm impressed with the Land Rover so far. Nice. It was snowing. And if you do like any of my videos, please like them. I've had, on the previous video that I've put in, I've had over 100 views but no likes. So if you like it, please take the time to click that thumb up. It would be much appreciated. Some cattle bread. Now what I'm trying to do here now is to try and stay on well-trodden snow. Pretty much the same route that I took up. Picking my way through. Ever since I've had this Land Rover, all it's done is impress me. Never thought there'd be a vehicle on the road that would be able to perform like this does. But it's also scared me a few times as well. I think it's not the Land Rover that's not capable of doing it. I definitely believe that it's me that's not capable of doing it. Like I said, I've only had it for 3 years anyway, so I'm newcomer to one.
awesome tools. I can see why the army do use them. Numerous armies around the world. Right, I have not changed gear, I'm still in the same gear. Start to flatten out around here a little bit. Still going roughly around 6 miles an hour. Intending to change that speed just yet. If I'm wrong, tell me. Not sliding at all. I thought it would. Remember, if you do slide, don't slam the brakes on. A little bit of acceleration to get the wheels going the same speed as the car, or in this case the Land Rover, and that should be able to get you. But now I'm changing speed up into second, low range, diff lock is still engaged. I'm just crawling now, 9 miles an hour. And this is pretty much it. And we'll take the roadway, because I've had enough excitement for one day. Slowing down quite nicely now because I can see the road in front. This has been the worst snow that we've had since I've been up here anyway. I've been living up here for roughly around, this is the third year, fourth year, something like that. Right. Now that we're on tarmac, apply the brakes, take it out of the diff lock. The light has not gone on, gone out, so that means the diff lock is still engaged. So what I shall do now, I shall select reverse gear and reverse for a little bit. Is out. Once it's out, put it into high range for normal road driving, select second gear and drive off and keep checking the light for a few yards just to make sure it stays out. It's still out, which is good news. Now we have a van coming up, so I'll reverse and get out of the way for it. thank you for watching. Like I said, if you like my videos, please give me a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.